Historically, reading has been seen as this kind of natural extension, as if there's language and then there's reading and writing, and reading and writing is just a kind of natural extension of language on paper. But that really misses something. With spoken language, we're talking about a process that, depending on which scientific expert you subscribe to, human beings have been doing for at least 100,000 years, some would argue a million years. Our brains have co-evolved, to use Terence Deacon's phrase, with language. Right? Language is so important to our brain that it will literally rewire itself to find a way to speak and listen. It's built in. Now, the particulars of the language, the environment that we're born into, we learn. But the capacities for language acquisition, for language production, we come with that. No such way with reading. Reading is a mechanical, technological, external, artificial overlay to language. And without understanding the difference between the natural language process and this artificial overlay, then the way that we think about reading and the way that we think about the struggle of learning to read is kind of misdirected, misoriented.